today we'll see, hope to see, four islands in total. Three on towards the western side and one towards the eastern side. Lagomera is the closest in the west. Oh yeah, tenemos el plan de ver doing something, you know, growing something there. Most of them, they are used to grow potatoes. And they have this very strange light colored beige, light yellow colored material in the terraces to grow potatoes. And that material is volcanic ash, pyroclastic material that has been used since hundreds of years to grow vegetables in. Here, earth ground is rich in rocks. There's more rocks than actual ground. That's the way to prepare the terraces. You need to do that to flatten the land. But then the actual humus is not present. So the only thing to do is to fill in the terrace with something that you would bring from around. And before the national park got declared in 1954, the pyroclastic ash material, since it's quite lightweight, it's easy to transport and to dig out, used to be brought over here and really to all the parts of the island to fill in these terraces to like a meter or 1.5 meters thick, and then you grow your potatoes in there, which makes it quite easy to plant, easy to harvest, no need for a shovel, and also it limits the need of watering it. The clear color makes the water, or makes the water stay inside, and limits the evaporation. You'll see some of these terraces here and a little bit higher up still, up until they enter the natural protected zone of the forest. Grapes, vineyards are also visible. We're getting to the highest or the widest spanning highland vineyard plantation in Tenerife. These vineyards do not require flat beds, so they can grow on the slope. These plants are quite tough. They can withstand the winter cold. It does get really cold here at these altitudes. It can get below zero in winter for a few weeks. And during the day, the temperature heats up. The sun, even in winter, is subtropical and goes away. So whenever it's not cloudy, and the sun really warms up the soil quite quickly. But then at night, the temperature falls to quite close to zero here in winter. In summer, it does fall to around 10 degrees, the lowest at the coast that ever happens, because the sea, the ocean, is very close, and it acts as a heat source or a battery of heat stored in there. So the ocean really starts off in winter, it cools down to around 17, 18 degrees, and the outside temperature is also wet.
Que la fusosa, que la otra un cauce, y tú de la escalera pasas al ascensor. nosotros. Sí. Pero hay un momento en el que tú te desenganchas de la escalera.
En un segundo, ¿eh?
Y tú pones el cabo en otro sitio del ascensor y tal, y das un paso desde la escalera al ascensor. Y estás agarrado. Porque tiene el cabo puesto.
Aber lustig, ich habe mehr Angst als hochfahren. Als loben, weil ihr da seid. So lustig.
Ich sehe euch da.
Nein, jetzt nicht. Mama, könntest du aufhören, das auszusprechen? Es ist eh schon schlimm genug, dass es wackelt, ja?
Deswegen ist die Frau. Wer kann das nicht
machen? Weil es muss man hier zu irgendwelchen Polizisten. Da sieht man so über die Lavaströme, die runtergegangen sind. Vielleicht ist das das, was frisch ausgebrochen ist vor 3 Jahren.
Neben Teide hast du keine Stange.
Teide heißt Zungen.
Weißt du, was Teide ist? Das Kind hat einen Weitwinkel.
Vielleicht deswegen, weil es so windig ist, dass ich nicht so schnell oben kommen. Ja, ja, ja. Ja, so fahren. Ich glaube, es ist so fahren. Ja, das ist schnell, das merkt man nämlich.
Thank you. No, no tenía.
Iba con los chavales de los play.
Non, c'est pas possible.